Former Congress MP of Warangal S. Rajaiah, his wife Madhvi and their son Anil have been detained by the Warangal police. Rajaiah's daughter-in-law and three of her sons were burnt alive in a rather mysterious fire that took place in the bedroom early on Wednesday morning. They were residing on the first floor of the former Congress MP's house. Rajaiah's daughter-in-law Sarika, who was the mother of the three sons, Abhinav, Ayan and Shreyan, died in a mysterious fire. The police are investigating if it was a case of a gas cylinder leak by accident or was there a suicide attempt. Now, there have been reports of differences within the family, as former Congress MP's daughter-in-law Sarika had complained of harassment by her husband Anil and her in-laws. She had even sat on a dharna outside the former MP's house along with her children in April last year. Okay, so now the police are investigating all the possible angles, and the former Congress MP of Warangal, S. Rajaiah, his wife and their son Anil have already been detained by the Warangal police, who are now questioning them. And those are the visuals of the young children and the wife there, Sarika, who is the daughter-in-law of S. Rajaiah. Editor South TS Sudhir joins us for more on this. So Sudhir, what really are the police, you know, looking at in this particular case? Was there a complaint of harassment that was filed by Sarika earlier?
Well, yes, there has been a case of harassment which was filed by Sarika earlier. That was in April 2014. So obviously that has given a different dimension to this entire case, which is why right in the morning, even though prima facie it looked like a case of a gas cylinder blast resulting in the death of Sarika and her three children, they were not really willing to go entirely by that. They were also looking at the possible background in which she had filed this harassment case against her husband and other members of his family. So now what the police is waiting for is a postmortem report, which is expected in a couple of hours. The family members, Rajaiah, his wife Madhvi, as well as his son Anil, who is Sarika's husband, they have been taken to the police station in Warangal for questioning. They have been detained there, and only after that some kind of a formal arrest could possibly be made, depending on what the postmortem report has to say. So the death, prima facie, that's what the commissioner of police there, Sudhir Babu of Warangal, confirming that the death was due to burn injuries, but whether they were self-inflicted or whether it was due to some kind of an accident, that is to be established only by the postmortem report.
Okay, so while the police are waiting for the postmortem report, are they questioning anyone else in this particular case of a possible, you know, family discord or, you know, conflict and friction within the family members?
Well, there have been some members of the family from Sarika's side who have come to Warangal and have actually alleged that these three people, Rajaiah, his wife and the husband of Sarika, had a role to play in harassing Sarika, which is probably the reason why they have been taken away from the house to the police station for questioning. So that will continue for the next 2 hours, though no formal arrest has been done so far. But yes, given the background to the entire case, given the allegations being made by Sarika's family members, obviously they have not given a clean chit to either the former Congress MP or his family members in this particular case.
You know, this is a very tragic incident. Your three young children and their mother, you know, losing their lives as a result of that mysterious fire. What else, you know, have the neighbors said, or what have you been able to gather from the police only about the fire that erupted all of a sudden?
Well, everyone is extremely baffled by the fact that the fire, the gas cylinder blast, took place on the first floor where Sarika and her three children were sleeping. This happened early in the morning. Rajaiah and his wife were on the second floor of the building, while the husband Anil Kumar was on the ground floor of the building. Nothing happened to the ground or the second floor of the building, and the entire impact was taken by the first floor. That is something which has baffled the Warangal police. Forensic teams have been working on the spot since morning, trying to collect clues as to what could happen. But yes, everything at this point in time depends first on the postmortem report, which is expected in a couple of hours. Okay. And of course, the clues that the forensic team picks up, that will provide the leads to this particular case. And of course, Rajaiah and his family members will also be questioned in this case.
All right. Sudhir, thanks so much for joining us and getting us all of those updates.